Smart Wargames hier, Let's Play John Tiller's Naval Campaigns Midway. We will assume command of Japanese submarine I-9, which commences an attack on a US carrier group. Which happened historically in a similar fashion. However, I think we will engage the Hornet, while historically the Wasp was engaged and sunk. Yeah, first I will use again this MB ruler tool. You don't need it, you can just do it. I recommend to do it on the screen or, just providing everything I need. You can use it, as, at least there's a freeware version. And yeah, first I want to find out the exact cause of this thing. Yeah, looks good. Yeah, this line seems fine. So we know, and yeah, activate the range grid. So we basically know where it goes. And yeah, I will use again a basic formula like in the first tutorial, basic mathematic principle. Yeah, speed, distance, time. And yes, there are millions of rule of thumb formulas, of whatever formulas, and this and that yard formulas. Use them, what floats your boat, what fires your torpedoes. But yeah, this is three values. If you can handle them, you can build everything on it. And I want to attack in a 90 degree fashion. We are already waiting here in our positions. And yes, this tool allows you to get multiple lines out. And yeah, the 90 degrees I will do by something like a mark 1. This looks for me like 90 degrees somewhat. And the distance is 320. Yeah, let's get into our fire position at 300 pixels. These are pixels. Close in a bit. Why 300? In the closest zoom level. Maybe need a third line anyways. In the closest zoom level, this game range grid is 1 nautical mile in scale, and in the closest zoom level, it depends on your screen, I guess. On my screen it is 200 pixels, so 300 pixels are what? 1.5 nautical miles, of course. Yeah, and we will need a third line. Yes, you can lock those lines here with this locker, so you not by accident touch it and move it around, and it even allows you to do the game again, which is great. However, unfortunately, if you move or zoom out, it will offset everything. Having something like this in game would be, of course, very beautiful. Yeah, we will speed up and move closer quickly because I don't think we will have much time. And what is the first calculation we want to have? Yes, we will want to know what is the time our torpedo requires to travel this 1.5 nautical miles. So, and the game provides us everything we need except for a calculator, which is built in every operating system. And the Type 95 torpedo is here. It is a torpedo running 50 knots. Let's pull out the calculator. 50 knots, okay, yes. And again, 1 knot is meaning 1 nautical mile per hour. And I recommend you to convert hours into seconds. 1 hour is 3600 seconds. And we know this torpedo runs 15 knots. So divided by 15 knots. And we know this torpedo needs 72 seconds to cross 1 nautical mile. However, we are flying from 1.5 nautical miles. So let's multiply it by the factor of 1.5. And now we have a value of 108 seconds. So from this point here up to here, the torpedo will require 108 seconds to the impact point. First calculation. Good, we will move into the fire position And next we will do the second calculation. We want to know what distance this aircraft carrier can cross in 108 seconds. And yeah, let's get the calculator out again. And yeah, speed is already given. Somebody calculated it of the submarine crew. In reality, it's a difficult part. It's also the bearing, but we know it. And yes, I will do some calculation steps you don't require, of course. You can skip them, but just to make it easier for folks that for all folks. First, I will divide 1 by 3600 seconds. And this little value here, this is 0.00 whatever, and is the distance traveled by a vessel of 1 knot in a second. So quite small, but we know this aircraft carrier doesn't travel 1 knot by with 1 knot. It travels with 27 knots. So multiply it by 27 knots. This is the distance this aircraft carrier travels in a second. But we want to know the distance it travels in 108 seconds. So again, multiply it by 108. And here's your value. Let's round it to 0.8, or 4/5 of a nautical mile. So, you know, 1 nautical mile is 200. So 4/5 is 160. Now we can take, we need to, and this we will simply place here. We can bring it a bit closer. And 160, yeah, looks good. When this aircraft carrier hits this line, you know, this barrier here, we will fire our torpedoes towards this point. The torpedoes will travel, and when they reach this, the aircraft carrier should be in this region. Sure, they will try to evade everything, yeah. Stuff like this happens, they will see the torpedoes perhaps. But yeah, let's continue the game. And yeah, one additional calculation, I won't do it in order not to get too much in a video. Normally you could submerge now and wait, because you know, see, it requires some time for the aircraft carrier. It is not that much to get here. And yeah, this game doesn't have upscope, downscope, but just, I hope they add it, and just you can go submerge in order to stay concealed from ships. I won't do it for, I also modified this a bit for those tutorial purposes, because their ships are quite good with their active sonars. They locate you at miles away, which made it really hard to get anywhere close. But luckily the game allows you to do some modifications on the parameters, like submarine visibility on surface, or so active sonar range. Okay. Yeah, let's run the game in real time. Get into the fire position here a bit closer. Yeah, and the third value, you could, for example, calculate the rest of the distance and what time the aircraft carrier will require to hit this, and then you could go conveniently into deep and wait for this time. Of course, not completely, because you need also to incorporate time for returning to the surface. But yeah, we won't do it, but you could. Yeah, the Japanese submarine force is quite overshadowed by the German submarine force, and of course also the highly successful US one. But this Japanese I-9 submarine was responsible for one of the most devastating and most effective torpedo salvos in history of warfare. It fired 6 torpedoes against the Wasp carrier group, hitting the Wasp 3 times, damaging a battleship, damaging a destroyer beyond repair, it was scuttled later, and it got pursued by ASW escorts. 90 death charges were fired against it, but it escaped unharmed. So yeah. Okay, we are ready. Yes, they are quite fast. We will soon launch. Yeah, let's hope that we won't get spotted. Our periscope, it's quite close. We lost visual to the aircraft carrier because the weather is a bit, also the water could be that is making it hard for the periscope. So we will regain visual. Come on. Here it is. Okay. It's not yet in position. Yeah, they also had some interesting designs. They were quite heavily into those aircraft carrier submarines, into those really big submarines as well, which could hold aircraft even with dedicated hangars. Not many, of course, but still made a difference. And yeah. Okay, we are now soon ready to launch. I will launch a salvo, like historically, of 6 torpedoes. I don't expect to do that much damage as the historical submarine, also because of the formation, because the battleship is absolutely far away. And yeah, again, it is not the same. I don't want to shift the camera because of the fire solution, but it was the other aircraft group that got engaged historically. Okay, almost. Can use the cruiser. Go. 6 torpedoes. I will spread them quite close. My primary target is the aircraft carrier. For the rest, I don't care. And there's also a big gap behind it, so unlikely. Okay, 6 torpedoes. Let's see, we'll fire one. Let's fire a close salvo. The 6th torpedo either in the front. No, let's fire back. And what will the aircraft carrier do? It will turn. It is already running at high speed. It can't speed up, it can't turn. It can only shorten the distance. Okay. Yeah, game is running, torpedoes are out. Normally you would of course immediately dive and get out of there. Sure, we can do it and but it is for tutorial purposes, and yeah, but it's fine. Salvo is quite close. It's interesting how it looks. Yeah, I could imagine that the armored cruiser spotted it. Are they turning? It looks in the beginning, it looked like it was way too far in front. But yeah, if you wait, you will see that it looks, it will come quite in good. Yeah, it could be that the aircraft carrier is turning. They noticed something. It's a big salvo. Perhaps the destroyer saw it. Not really. And look at this. This will definitely score a hit. It is now in the trap. Yeah, it disappeared. It might be because of weather, but it is there. Wait, we can turn on cheat in order to counteract the weather. And you see it, it is basically exactly like the firing solution in the center. Now it is maneuvering, but there's it is of course trying to make the surface smaller against the torpedo salvo, but that's definitely will assume one or two hits minimum. Oh yeah. Oh, could be even that it was three or four hits. It was too fast. But this thing is absolutely wasted. Yeah, two torpedoes going, but I don't think they will hit anything. Yeah, let's go deep. And yeah, that is basically concluding the tutorial. Southwest, let's escape. Yeah, rudder is stuck, I guess heavy flooding. And yeah, there are some aircraft, Japanese aircraft carriers operating. Yeah. Okay. And now the real battle will begin. The battle against, yeah, we can remove the solution again. Job done. Okay. Yeah, there are several submarines, not many games that portray Japanese submarines, so if you're looking into this, here is pictures. They have different types of Japanese submarines. This looks quite futuristic. Yeah, it would be interesting if this game is coming with some of those aircraft carrier submarines, but at least they do not carry float. I mean, all systems in the engine are in place. You can launch float planes from surface ships, so should be possible to program submarines like this. Okay, that's it. Have fun.